So let's look at network theories. Entrepreneurs come to existence because of availability of existence networks, strong social ties, informal and formal, which support the development of entrepreneurship. The network can consist of suppliers, financial markets, information networks, networks for solving business problems. Yes, this is it. So this is true that entrepreneurship can be source of strong networking. As you have seen, strong networking, it is the indicator of successful entrepreneurs. So if you are born a family where they have a strong existing strong network, this can help you in entrepreneurship, your entrepreneurship activity. But not only this, there is also a way of being successful entrepreneurship while you are offering good products and good services. Build your networking from now if you want to become a good entrepreneur. A strong networking with your customers, with your colleagues at the school, with your lecturers, with whoever you meet. Because those ones are the future, are your future suppliers or customers. Psychological theories focus on the person of the entrepreneur. People start a business because they possess certain characteristics, example, need to achieve internal locus of control, tolerance, and ambiguity, risk taking. Certain psychological threats predispose people to entrepreneurship. The supply of entrepreneurship depends on individual cheap needs for the achievement rather than the desire for money. Yes, it's a psychological theory. Some people become entrepreneur due to the needs of achievement, hence the success in entrepreneurship. Now, why do entrepreneurs initiate their own business? Do you want to be independent? Do you want to have immediate needs for a job? Do you not to implement the income, to supplement the income? They need to develop a business for their children, to prove one's ability as entrepreneurs, to exploit the opportunities and opportunities they have skills. Recently, I have given you a segment about the richest people in the world. And who you provided a list of people who are rich and their career and their net worth. But I have seen no one who is not an entrepreneur. All rich people are entrepreneurs. So there is no rich person who is employed. So if you want to become rich, please think about your own business. If you want to become a poor person, please join other people, look for job, apply for job. But if you want to become rich and change life, to make a difference, think about your own business. Have a bright business idea. Think about what can you do to serve society, to make change. So, why do people leave paid job to start their own business? There is like follows order. A bit is not being, their ability sometimes are not recognized. Income is at a set level. If you are receiving like 500,000 monthly, you will finish almost 10 years receiving the same amount. But an entrepreneur keep on increasing the profit and changing from one side to another side. So, the responsibility is limited. When you are employed, you will have a limited responsibility. Implementation of new ideas is difficult. If you have your own business, if you are working for other people, you can't implement your own business idea dependent on the employer. Actually, like this time for COVID-19, yes, some business also have stopped. But the other people who are employed, depending on it, on the income generation, which is the employment, salary only, they have got difficult, numerous problems, face challenges, because they can't survive if their bosses cannot pay salary. So depend on the employment opportunity and limited. So people who want to become rich and who want to live a different, to make a difference, think always about entrepreneurship opportunity. So what are the challenges of being self-employed? The scope of business opportunity.